Hey, what is up, everyone? Welcome back to another Gunpla review, and today I'm taking a look at the absolutely massive 1/48 scale mega size unicorn Gundam. To be honest, it's going to be a pretty hard review to pull off because I can barely fit this thing in frame. Actually, to be honest, I can't. But anyway, this thing is pretty cool, so let's try and do this. Here we go. And by the way, if you haven't checked out the unboxing or the speed build, make sure to do so now. Finally, there is what it looks like completely put together, and this thing looks insanely good. Of course, the best aspect and the most obvious aspect about this thing is it is huge. Absolutely huge. As for size comparisons, there it is side by side with a high grade, the real grade Unicorn Gundam, a Figma. There it is making the Master Grade Full Armor Gundam Verka look like a high grade, beside the Perfect Grade Strike Gundam, and finally there it is beside the Perfect Grade Unicorn Gundam. So as you can see, this thing is colossal. As for the aesthetics, this thing looks fantastic. The proportions are perfect, it looks so good. The surface detailing on this kit is very nice. It would need it being this big, but as you can see, without panel lining, it doesn't pop so much. So make sure to get this thing panel lined and all that detail just instantly pops. It looks great. As for colors, we've got the navy blue on the feet and backpack. Of course, all of that white, some light gray. The red sections of the Psycho frame are a bit more transparent than I've seen on the Perfect Grade and the Real Grade, and the color itself seems more reddish to me. Not as pinky red as those other two kits, more of a just standard red. We've got clear green parts on the head camera as well as the eyes. I didn't use the foil seals for the eyes and it doesn't look that good. I'm gonna have to change these out to make those eyes stand out. Last up then is the V-fin, which is just kind of in a yellow. No stickers in here and no options, and as you can see around here on the back, it is yellow as well. So if you want this to be accurate, you will have to paint the back of it, but either way, it still looks good from the front. As for nub marks, they're not so bad considering I just pulled this thing from the runners just like it says you can. If you wanted to look a little bit cleaner, then chop them out with the nippers, but for just manhandling this thing right out of the runners, it still looks fantastic. Moving on to articulation, and as for the head, it's got a really big ball joint in there and doesn't move around too much. As for the arm at the shoulder, that's it all the way up. That can rotate all the way around. That's it for the bend at the elbow, rotation at the wrist, rotation at the waist. Beam sabers in the backpack can move. Side skirt up and down and a bit of a wiggle, that's on a ball joint. Side skirt up and out, as well as back and forward. The leg all the way up to the front. All the way out to the back, but it is blocked by the butt flap skirting armor. The legs all the way out, so this thing can nearly almost do the splits. Right there is the bend at the knee. Ankle armor flap up and down. And last up at the ankle, we have the toes all the way down, all the way up again, a little bit of side-to-side tilt, but absolutely zero, and I mean zero, rotation here. So there is the mega-sized Unicorn Gundam with everything that it comes with. So first off, we've got the shield. Again, no transformation here. That's the front. That right there is the back. This is the only moving part, this part for attaching it into the back of the forearm. And just to give you an idea on how big this shield is, that is a high-grade box, and this is the shield. So it's too big to fit in a high-grade box. Also, there is the Perfect Grade shield for comparison. So there is bottom to bottom, and that's the size difference. Next up is the Beam Magnum, and why the hell not? There is a high-grade box for a size comparison once again, and there is a comparison with the Perfect Grade's Beam Magnum. Also, it's worth noting we've got a really nice clear green piece in the lens there. Next, a pair of beam sabers big enough to be used as chopsticks. Two part separators, a big sheet of water slide decals. As for manipulators, we've got two types, trigger finger holding hands, as well as fists. The shield attaches into these slots in the forearm, either the front or the back. The beam saber handles can be attached onto the backpack. The beam sabers can be held in the trigger finger hands, which do look a little bit odd, and the beams do look a little bit too small for it. Lastly then, you can flip out the parts on the back of the forearms and attach the beams into those sabers there. The Beam Magnum can be held in the hand, has this moving handle here on the side, and the wrists actually have more articulation than I gave them credit for earlier on. When not in use, it can be attached onto the back of the forearm, or flip this little piece out to attach it onto the backpack. So that is it for the review, and I have to say I am absolutely smitten with this kit. It is awesome. I really didn't know what to expect going into this, but it's a super simple build. I mean, it's the simplest. I mean, this is something you could literally sit down with your kids and build. It's that easy. But the payoff in the end is ridiculous. You get a massive, fantastic looking kit. Just for the end of this video, I decided to change the eyes to the reflective ones, look so much better, as well as add some of the water slides on there. But if you added all of them, it would even look that much better. Sure, the Real Grade and the Perfect Grade are fantastically engineered kits, but at the end of the day, all your Gunpla is going to end up on your shelf, right? Real Grades and High Grades, even Master Grades, may look cool up close, but once you get far away, they just look small. But that is where this thing shines. From a distance, you will not miss this thing. It just has so much presence, way more than even the Perfect Grade. If you want something for on your shelf and something that looks fantastic, this is it right here. I remember a couple of years back when I used to live in another city here in Japan. When I used to walk to the convenience store at night, I would always see two mega-sized models, that was the Age as well as the standard Granddaddy Gundam, up in a window, and you could see them from so far away and make out what they were. This right here is a statement. If you want yourself a centerpiece, this right here is that centerpiece. I really have to say, once you build something this big and this beautiful, everything else you have just pales in comparison. So to sum it up, if you want a really detailed, well-engineered kit, this isn't it. If you want something that is only mildly poseable, but makes a huge statement on your shelf, then this is the one you want. I love it. For the 7,000 yen that this thing cost me, it was worth every single yen. But anyway, I'm starting to ramble a bit now, but I highly, highly recommend this kit. Anyway, as always, thank you very much for watching. Leave a like if you want, it does help out the channel. And as always, make sure to come back for more Gunpla reviews, and I'll see you next time.